Hey, welcome back to Albany County Fasteners, Fasteners 101. I'm Bob, and today we're going to talk about black oxy process. So let's get started. Black oxy, what is it? Black oxy is a conversion coating formed by an alkaline aqueous salt solution. There are two processes in black oxy. You have a hot process and a cold process. Cold process does not meet government or mill spec and will have color variations. And there are four different classes with black oxy. Black oxy has classes 1 through 4. The typical ones being used is class 1 and 4 for fasteners. Class 1 basically runs between 285 degrees and 290 degrees as the process is baked. Class 4, which is for stainless steel, is a 250 degree process. So what I have here presently right now are fasteners that have been black oxied from stainless. These are all stainless parts that have been sent out and black oxy process was applied. Some of these parts have different finishes as far as how dark and pigment they are versus others. The flat washers, as you can see here, have some minor scratches or imperfections. And on washers, they're not always going to be totally 100% black. You can see some variations in some of them. Some will be purely black. I've seen them both ways. Sometimes we've sent them back for reprocessing. It's just the nature of the process that you have to deal with. Like this socket cap screw, which I've seen this time and time again. I have two here. I have a larger one and a smaller one. The smaller one is a little more darker than the larger. The larger one's almost more like a pigmented gun finish. And with that process, you can have different patinas on them. It's all a matter of how they process and how long they put it through the process to complete it. And some of these, the typical process for black oxy is rinse, black oxy, rinse again, finish coat. That's the typical finish. We stock a lot of black oxy products. A couple of products here that can be done that we don't have here presently is nylon lock nuts. They have a nylon part in those and they need to be protected before they go through the process so it does not change the physical condition of the nylon so it locks the nut in place. I want to go through the 5 basic steps for black oxy, which are clean, rinse, black oxy, rinse again, supplementary finish. The supplementary finish is what protects the black oxy for long time use. The coatings are oil, wax, paint, or lacquer. So depending upon your condition and what you're applying this to, that will change how you finish your black oxy. So this particular one, this button head, has wax on it. This was put in wax, spun, and finished. Typical process for black oxy is black oxy and then oil spun off. That is the typical when someone does not specify. So oil finish will give you a glossy finish. wax finish will give you a matte finish. Paint or lacquer will give you a satin finish or a glossy finish, depending upon what you specify. It all depends on what you want your black oxy to be. We can send your product out if you want us to and have it done to your specifications. Black oxy on stainless will yield excellent corrosion protection, primarily due to their inherited properties. So when you black oxy stainless, chances are it's going to be more resistant for corrosion. Now keep in mind that black oxy finish with oil in a salt water condition will eventually show some type of rust. Same thing if you put black oxy on your car or your truck and you drive the vehicle in salt on the streets, you will see corrosions on these fasteners. So you're going to want to coat your black oxy accordingly. And that's really what it comes down to. We have a customer who sells his product that he puts our fasteners into. And those fasteners, he first has a black oxy. He then sends it out to be painted black, and then he lacquers it. So when it goes into a saltwater environment, he will not experience, or his customer will not experience, any rust. Or another way to prevent rust would be to black oxy 316 stainless. That should, finish it. But 316 is very expensive. It's not cheap. So you have to pay for that. As far as hot and cold finish, hot and cold. Cold, these are all parts done in hot black oxy. Cold finish, how you can tell is cold will start to rub off. You can take your hand and you can rub it and the black oxy will rub off. This will not rub off. So the hot process is the best process. Cold process will chip, it will scrape, you will have issues as far as black oxy goes in a cold finish. Colors will change if you're using black oxy in a 900 degree or higher environment. So if you're going to put the black oxy parts into 900, 1000 degrees, you're going to see variations in the color happen as it's in that environment. If you're going to have your parts black oxide and your parts are rusty or scaling, you will require to have the parts cleaned before they can be black oxide. In other words, it would have to go into an acid pickle to clean the parts and then rinse them back off again, and then go through the process of black oxy. Plated parts, such as alloyed with zinc plating on it, or alloyed with hot dip galvanized plating, all those platings would have to be removed prior to black oxying. Black oxy only works on alloyed or stainless steel products that are free of any other foreign products on it. So no oils, no grease, no platings. It's got to be clean parts. Plating can be done to direct alloyed parts or stainless steel parts, series 18-8, 300, and 400 series. Anything other than that, a 316 or other special stainlesses will require to be reviewed for how dark your plating will be as far as, or your black oxy process will be. Welding black oxy does not produce noxious fumes or hamper the ease which parts can be welded. So, in closing of black oxy, this is a process that many gun dealers, knife, car products are use these this type of hardware in their applications. It's an awesome look. People love it. We stock loads of this stuff, and we also send out custom orders for processing. There you go. Today you learned about black oxy process, cold and hot process. Subscribe, like, comment, visit us at albanycountyfasteners.com for 50,000 SKUs right off the rack, ready to ship. See you in our next video.